Welcome to this brief guide on how to use ChatGPT in Google Docs. Tools such as large language models and ChatGPT are great assets for you to be able to use to be more productive. Today I'm going to show you how to utilize them in Google Docs. Here you can see I have my Google Docs currently open, and we're going to utilize an extension to add ChatGPT in. But the first thing we'll need to do is head to the OpenAI developer portal, which can be accessed at platform.openai.com. The link will be in the description of this video, and you'll need to create an account or sign in, but please note you can use your Google account or Microsoft account if you prefer. Once signed in, click on your profile in the top right-hand corner, and then from the menu option, you want to select View API Keys. The API key is what we're going to use to make this tool work. From here, we'll need to select the option that says Create New Secret Key. Now, please note you should never share this key with anyone, as this is a private key for you to utilize. Use the green button to be able to copy it into your clipboard and select OK to close this page down. Now we can head back over to our document, and in the Extensions menu, we're going to select the option that says Add-ons, and then from there, select the option that says Get Add-ons. This is going to open up the Google Workspace Marketplace, where you can use the search box at the top and search for ChatGPT, all one word, and the top search result should be GPT for Sheets and Docs. This is the extension that we're going to install today. As you can see, I currently already have it installed, but if you don't, click on the Install button and then sign in with your preferred Google account in order to add it to Google Docs for yourself. Now that we have the extension installed, we do need to finalize the setup on it. And to do so, we highlight the extension and select the option that says Set API Key. From here, we'll get a pop-up in the middle of our window where we can then paste in our OpenAI API key. Once you've pasted it in, select the button that says Check just to make sure that your key is valid. And once you've confirmed that your API key is valid, select the button that says Save API Key. Now that we've done that, our extension is ready to be used. To access it, select Extensions in your toolbar, select GPT for Sheets and Docs, and then finally select the option that says Launch Sidebar. This will take a couple of seconds, but then on the right-hand side of our window, we'll have the side pane open up with our extension ready to be used. The first step will be to choose our action. At the moment, it's set for Write Custom Prompt, but as you can see, there are a lot of options available to you, such as fixing grammar and spelling, summarizing a document, translating. In this case, we'll start off with using a custom prompt. Then inside the text field, we can then simply type in our prompt. I already have one in my clipboard, so I'll simply paste it in, which is saying, write a blog post about traveling around Japan for 3 weeks from the perspective of a travel blogger. I've mentioned also that the post should have a fun vibe and not be too analytical. And now that I've got my prompt completed, I could simply click on the submit button. But before I do that, I can go down to the bottom of this extension and customize some options further. Starting with selecting the model, so depending on which models are available at the time, you could select from one of the others, such as for instance GPT-4. In this case, I'm going to select GPT 3.5 Turbo, and then I head down to the temperature section. This is a number anywhere between 0 and 1, which scales up for the level of creativity that the AI is able to utilize when responding to your prompt. Then you need to select the maximum number of response tokens that are allowed to be utilized from your account for this response. 10 tokens equals roughly 7 words in English. And down the bottom here, you can see the maximum number of input tokens that are able to be used based on the type of prompt and model that you have selected. Once we're done, we click on Submit, and this is where the magic happens. ChatGPT is basically creating the response for us. It'll take a few moments, but then we'll be able to see our prompt history right here, and we'll be able to hover over any of the options in our history to be able to see exactly how many tokens were utilized for that response. And there's my response. It's a 7-paragraph blog post. Looks pretty good to me so far, but I could go through and check it all out further if I'd like. Or I can actually use a further action and choose to summarize it. So let's see what happens when we summarize this. In the text field, we need to enter in how we would like this document to be summarized. And in my case, I'm going to ask for a bullet point summary. This won't take too long, given that it's not a lot of text in the document at the moment. Click on Submit. And in no time at all, I have my summary created and it's been automatically addended to the bottom of the document here. And as I can see, I've got a quick summary, tells me that the author recently went on a trip to Japan, they visited the Meiji Shrine, Tokyo Tower, and enjoyed some street markets and food. And those are just a couple of the cool ways that you can utilize ChatGPT in Google Docs. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and it saves you plenty of time in the future. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.